If I have to give you a short introduction to OpenJTS, I would say the main goal of this tool is to make the life of our customer and user easier when they wish to start playing with gRPC streaming telemetry. In a few clicks, user could enable the collection and visualization of the most common data provided by Juniper's telemetry solutions. OpenJTS is built around well-known open source tools such as Telegraph for telemetry collections, Capacitor for performing aggregations or alarming, InfluxDB as a time series database, and finally Grafana for data visualizations. From my side, I'm just adding two specific pieces of software. The first one concerns Telegraph. Actually, we rely on a fork of this tool to leverage several new plugins I developed to facilitate pre-aggregations, data enrichment or alarming, but as well as to enhance the data collection with a slightly modified GNMI plugin and the development of a new Juniper Netconf input plugin, sometimes useful in case where data are not yet available through gRPC. The second model I developed aims to orchestrate the stack. This is a kind of adaptation layer. This module, called JTSO, is the only entry point to manage the OpenJTS stack. All is done via a simple web GUI. JTSO is in charge of configuring all the components of the stack. JTSO also includes its dedicated Netconf collector for pulling periodically additional metadata for enrichment purposes. As seen, those metadata are re-injected directly into Telegraph via a new dedicated plugin. Okay, it's time to play with OpenJTS. Let's start the stack. First, we need to clone the OpenJTS repository. Please note that tuning the installation is still possible, like changing port banding, using TLS for gRPC, or configuring HTTPS for the portal. The full procedure is described in the README file. As you can see, we leverage Docker Compose to deploy the stack in one single command. The stack is started. You should have access to this simple GUI. The main page shows you the state of each container. Containers up or green, containers down or red. JTSO automatically shuts down unused containers. Also, as you can see, there is one container instance per platform. One for VMX, one for MX, another one for PTX, and the last one for ASX. For each collector instance, you know the total number of collected routers. For instance, here we have two MX routers collected by the MX Telegraph instance. All is managed automatically. The only thing you can do there is to empty the whole DB to restore a clean state of your DB when needed. Then, let's move to the credential menu. In these versions, there is no per router credential, but it could be implemented in a future version. So, as of now, all connection parameters are shared by all routers. You need to configure a Netconf username password for the router discovering phase and also for the enrichment. You also may need a gRPC username password. And finally, you can also configure some other parameters related to TLS. All these options are detailed in the README file. So next step is to fill the router inventory. Once again, it's pretty straightforward. You just need to fill a short name and the full hostname or IP address of your router. Then, automatically, a Netconf session is established to retrieve some facts, like the family of the router, the model, and the version. Now, let's move to the profile menu. The profile is just a set of config files that follow some rules and naming conventions. Those files are used by JTSO to reconfigure the stack in real time. But just before assigning a router to a profile, let's have a look at Doc menu. On this page, you have access to some additional profile informations. For example, if I select one profile, you should see this kind of memory card, which summarizes which sensor we use to build the specific profile. For each sensor, you have a color that indicates if it's a native or open config path. And for each sensor, you have the list of counters we extracted to make the profile. You also have a few more details, such as a short description of the profile, on which platform the profile is supported, and other informations related to Grafana and Capacitor. For the telemetry collections, we support a per platform and per version config file, if needed. So it means that if there are slight differences between two Junos versions, such as a counter rename, we can easily patch the profile to take into account these small deviations. This kind of deviations happen sometimes, especially with open config models. Let's move back to the profile menu and assign our newly added router to one or several profiles. As of today, there are several well-known profiles. But as I said, a profile is just a set of config files, and we will add more profiles over the time. So, just after pressing the button, JTSO will manage the reconfiguration of all the different components. This will take only a few seconds. If we move back to the main page, we can see now we are collecting 3 MX routers. Nice! Before moving to Grafana, let's have a look at the Analyzer module. Click on the Browse menu first. For troubleshooting purposes, or if you look for more information regarding a given sensor, we also provide what we call a telemetry analyzer. With this simple module, you can browse a specific path on a specific router. Let's try with the well-known platform path from OpenConfig. This one begins by /components/component. And then let's select our newly powerful platform we recently advertised, the PTX10002. There is also one option for managing data. This one is explained in the README file. For now, unset the option and let's start the analysis. As you can see, we first establish a GNMI session and we start extracting all the XPaths, part of the sensor. This takes about a minute. Once done, the result of the analysis will be displayed as a simple tree view. As you can see, some XPaths have nodes with attributes. In this example, two nodes of this XPath have a K attribute, which is named for the node component and also named for the node property. If I expand the tree, you should see first the list of possible components name. And if I expand one level more, you will see, in our case for the FPC component name, the list of property name attached to this FPC. There are also a few options to navigate in the tree. You can use these buttons to collapse or expand all the tree. And with this simple search input, you can highlight all the XPaths or counter matching the search string. Let's illustrate by looking for power KPIs. As seen, all XPaths or key or even value matching the search strings are highlighted in red. Let's move on and switch to Grafana to have a look at some pre-included dashboards. First, we could try the router health profile. Here, you have access to many KPIs related to the health of the router. For instance, you can see the current CPU and memory consumptions of all active components, like the array and the FPC. You know how many alarms are currently raised. This specific panel shows you traffic real-time errors. Actually, these KPIs don't come from the router. They are automatically derived from telemetry data. In other words, they are generated by a dedicated telegraph plugin, the alarming plugin I developed for these purposes. We also leverage GNMI on-chain to access in real time to the latest syslogs. Below, we display the detail of the current chassis alarms and FPC. In this two-dex table, you have the detail of the derived real-time traffic alarms generated thanks to the alarming telegraph plugin. Let's scroll down a bit to see the history of the CPU and memory of both Aries and all FPCs. You see also the per process CPU consumption, the per core CPU, and the per process memory consumption graph. If we scroll down at the end of this dashboard, you will have access to some fabric states, such as the fabric drop in PPS and the input and output fabric throughput in PPS as well. We can try a second dashboard, for example, the optical profile. Let me select the specific node. And so here we talk about layer 1 and layer 2 states. You have access, thanks again to the telegraph alarming plugin, to all the links that have right now some framing errors. The two next table give you some nice overall view of optic state. The first one provides for each port and lane the RX and TX current levels. The second table shows you all the current optic alarms. Finally, if we scroll down, for each optic, you will find out several different layer 1 and layer 2 KPIs. As a conclusion, I would say OpenJTS is a kind of all-in-one telemetry tool for lab or pre-production. But don't forget, this is also your tools, and please feel free to open a GitHub issue as though for tracking issues or profile deviations, experience with a given release or platform, for example. Unfortunately, I was not able to test each profile against each release, so you could maybe encounter some minor issue. But as said, the tool is flexible and already supports per version profile, so a profile can be fixed in a day if needed. Moreover, don't hesitate to use the GitHub issue to also ask me for adding new profiles for your use cases. I will aggregate your requests and try to add periodically new profiles. I welcome all comments, improvements, or ideas. So enjoy playing with OpenJTS, and thank you for your attention.